Hello everyone, in the previous video we discussed about the direct method to find the mean of a continuous data. In this video we will discuss about the second method to calculate the mean, that is assumed mean method. So first of all write the formula for assumed mean method. Here mean, that is x bar, is equal to a plus sigma fi di upon sigma. So this is the formula to calculate the mean, a plus sigma fi di upon sigma fi. You know that sigma fi is the sum of all frequencies. This is the new term here, that is a. This a is called assumed mean. This is the assumed mean, and how to find the assumed mean we will discuss in the question. So a is called assumed mean. There is new term di. This di is called, this is called deviation. And how to find the deviation? Di is equal to xi minus e. So this is the formula, a plus sigma fi di upon sigma fi. A is called the assumed mean. Di is called the deviation. This is calculated by xi minus a. So let us see the question number 4 now. So this is the data given in question number 4 of exercise 14.1. We will find the mean by assumed mean method. So first step is to find the class mark, that is xi. And how to calculate xi? Lower limit plus upper limit by 2. So the first class mark will be 65 plus 68 by 2. This will be equal to 66.5. Similarly, the next class mark will be 69.5, 72.5, 75.5, 78.5, 81.5, and last one is 84.5. These are the class marks. Next we have to calculate the DI, that is deviation. But first of all we have to find the value of this A, that is assumed mean. So what is the value of A? Let us see all the class marks here. There are in total 7 class marks, from 66.5 to 84.5. So since there are 7 class marks, so we will take the middle class mark, that is 4th class mark. This 755.5. This value will be assumed as A. Clear everyone? So since there are odd numbers of class marks, so it is easy to find the middle term, that is the fourth term will be the middle term, A will be 75.5. Now we have to find the DI. What is DI? DI is xi minus A. We will subtract value of A from every class mark. So 66.5 minus 75.5, minus 9. This will be minus 6, minus 3, 0, 3, 6 and 9. So these are value of fi di. Now we have to find the value of fi di. So we will multiply fi with di. So this will be 2 into minus 9, minus 18, minus 24, minus 9, 0, 21, 24 and 18. So these are the values of fi di. Now we have to calculate the sum, that is sigma fi di. So calculate the sum here. This will be equal to 12, and here the sigma fi is 30. So this is the sum here. Now we have to calculate the mean by using the formula. So we will put the value here. What is the formula for mean? A plus sigma fi di upon sigma fi. So what is the value of A? A is 75.5. What is sigma fi di? This is 12. And what is sigma fi? This is 30. So this let's see question number 5. Number of mangoes are given 50 to 52, 53 to 55, 56 to 58. So here we can see that the data is not continuous. The upper limit here is 52 and the lower limit here is 53. So we have to make it continuous, and we have studied in class 9 how to make it continuous. What is the gap here? Gap is of 1, so we will take the half of 1, that is 0.5. And we will subtract 0.5 from lower limit and add 0.5 to the upper limit, then it will be converted into continuous data. So this will be converted into 49.5 to 52.5, 52.5 to 55.5, and in similar way 55.5 to 58.5, 58.5 to 61.5, and here 61.5 to 64. Now we can see that this data is converted into continuous data. Next we have to find the class mark. What is class mark here? First class mark will be 51, 54, 57, 60, 63. Now we have to find the value of A. To check the value of A, we will count the class marks. Since there are odd number of class marks, that is 5, so we will take the third value, that is the median value, 57. This will be our A. Next we have to calculate DI minus A. DI which is equal to xi minus a. So we will subtract 57 from 51. Minus 6, minus 3, 0, 3, and 6. So we can see that the sum of all DIs is always 0. Next we will calculate FIDI, and the value of FIDI should be multiplied FI into DI. The first value will be minus 90, minus 330, 0, 345, and this will be 1. Clear? These are FIDI. Now we have to take the total of these FIDIs. So sigma FIDI is, this will be equal to 75, and here take the total of all FIs, this is equal to 400. So now the last time we have to put the values in the formula. So x bar will be equal to 57 plus 75 upon 400. This will be equal to 3 by 16. 57 plus 0.187. X bar will be equal to 57.187. Or approximately we can say that 57.19. So this is the mean. By assumed mean method, the formula is this. A is called assumed mean, DI is called the deviation. So in the next video, we will discuss about the step deviation method. That is the last method to find the mean. So thank you so very much.